7 of 9. Tertiary adjunct of Unimatrix 01. It's been too long.
We're prisoners on an alien ship. Voyager has no idea we're missing, and the doctor's been decompiled.
The reports of my decompilation have been greatly exaggerated.
Doc?
Please state the nature of the medical emergency.
Seven downloaded my program into her cybernetic matrix.
An interesting sensation, to say the least.
And now you're in control of Seven's body?
Total control, it seems.
You could take the classes with me. Earn your own commission.
I believe I've already assimilated enough Starfleet training.
Give me a hand with this?
I'm surprised your Starfleet training didn't include cork extraction. This experience will make a fascinating article for the Starfleet Medical Journal. Ow!
Careful. That's not your body, remember?
Please state the nature of the medical emergency.
There isn't one. Yet.
I don't smell anything.
It could be an airborne toxin. Do you think they're trying to poison us? It's you.
It's been a busy day. I guess I'm perspiring a little.
A little? Seven's had a busy day, too, and she's come through it smelling like the proverbial rose. Slice these vegetables transversely in 5-millimeter increments.
Aye, aye.
I had no idea that eating was such a sensual experience. The tastes, the textures, feeling it slide down Seven's esophagus. It's exquisite.
They're prison rations.
Does this contain enough sodium chloride for your taste?
Could use another 0.6 milligrams, but you're the chef.
During my time with the Collective, we assimilated thousands of cultures from one end of the galaxy to the other. I'll say this for the Borg, we certainly do travel.
Your own recipe.
It's a mixture of metabolic enzymes and protein extract.
Let me make you one of my Talaxian omelets. It may not have as many enzymes, but it'll taste better.
How do I know you're not trying to poison me?
Oh, please. Oh, I never imagined.
Is this the first time you've tried that?
Of course not. It's just that I usually avoid foods that are this rich. I do have a figure to maintain. Oh, I better get another for you. Computer, another slice of cheesecake. Here. Your technique is flawed.
Sorry, I'm a replicator man.
Don't worry, Anson. I can take care of myself. My compliments to the chef. Preparing meals myself is the best way to ensure quality.
I suppose I should be insulted, but everything is so delicious, I may just have to admit defeat and hang up my apron.
No, that'd be a real tragedy, Neelix.
Pinot Noir, Commander?
I'll have another glass of the Chardonnay.
Each course has been paired with a specific wine. Substitutions are not recommended.
The Pinot Noir sounds perfect.
Is there any salt?
Additional seasoning is not required.
I'm sorry, I...
If the quail hasn't been prepared to your satisfaction, I could replicate something more to your liking. A peanut butter and jelly sandwich, perhaps.
Actually, it's delicious, just the way it is.
You improvised your way through an entire cheesecake, as well as 3 servings of Katerian chocolate puffs. Now I have to suffer the consequences.
The flowers are lovely, aren't they, Seven?
Thank you. I'll admire them later.
And if I don't want to?
What you want is irrelevant.
Why are you acting like this? Is it because you think you're dying?
I am dying.
Really? Because it looks to me like you're about to lose.
How does Scott?
You'll have to stay here for observation.
I think I've been sufficiently observed.
Are you offering me my last meal?
Of course not. Is that what you thought?
I was attempting to lighten the mood.
Ah, yes. Well done.
Ah, nice to see you, Ensign.
Are you drunk?
It wasn't my fault. Seven's unique physiology is unique. It doesn't react well to synthahol.
What happened?
Captain Rannick and I shared a meal aboard the Flyer. He's really a gentleman once you get to know him.
You had a dinner date in Seven's body?
It wasn't a date. It was a tactical maneuver designed to win the trust of our captors. And it worked.
I won't ask what you had to do to get this.
Nothing unladylike, I assure you. They lost their medic in a recent skirmish, and I offered to take his place.
Let's download your program before they change their mind. Be careful where you point those tubules.
Sorry.
Better late than never. Titus Livius, A History of Rome.
You're relieved.
Seven. Is everything all right?
I need your tricorder.
Nice to see you too.
I lost mine.
Oh, and Seven?
Yes.
I'm sorry I gave away your favorite phase compensator.
I was hoping you could provide a quotation to help alleviate my guilt.
I can't think of one, but I'd be happy to search the database.
Talk about perfection.
If you're attempting to embarrass me, you won't succeed.
I'm just observing humanity.
Without a doubt, that would have to be Lieutenant.
What happened?
Your time has expired.
You could have let the man finish his sentence.
I believe your ego has received enough stroking for one day.
I expect both of you to show up.
I'll be busy here.
What's wrong, Seven? No baby showers in the collective?
To the newest member of our crew, may all her desires be fulfilled except for one. So she'll always have something to strive for.
Oh, very good.
Here.
And may she inherit a sense of logic from her mother.
I'll drink to that.
They're lined with biothermal insulation. Your infant's feet will be protected even if the external temperature drops below minus 40 degrees Celsius. There's a photograph of my parents in the ship's database. I'll make a copy and place it in a frame.
Good, good.
A multispectral star chart might enhance this bulkhead.
Or a painting.
A painting of a star chart.
I was thinking of something more abstract, more artistic. Drapes. Nothing livens up a room like good window dressing. Not to mention the added privacy.
Privacy. We're in space.
Well, you never know when we'll be docking at a crowded spaceport.
Rock-a-bye, baby, in the space dock. When the core blows, the shuttle will rock. When the hull breaks, the shuttle will fall. And down will come, baby, shuttle and all.
Are you trying to soothe the infant or traumatize her?
If it's any consolation, I share your discomfort with social gatherings.
They seem to occur with alarming frequency. You have an appealing coiffure. What is your grooming regimen?
You're asking me what I do with my hair?
Yes. Ensign Kim is his usual chipper self. As for me, I'm looking forward to a long, uneventful shift in sickbay.
Oh! Oh, I was dreaming we found the Dilithium. We're back aboard Voyager.
Dreaming is an accurate description.
Didn't we already scan this nebula?
Four times.
I thought the Borg were known for being thorough.
The Borg value efficiency, not redundancy. There are only two of you. If I were to assimilate you into a small Borg collective, you could then assimilate others. The work would proceed more quickly.
Sorry, but I like my plan better.
He's persistent.
Not to worry. I'll make it clear to him that persistence is futile.
The hourly status report you requested.
Thanks.
Why have you brought these items aboard?
They make me feel more at home.
We'll only be on this vessel for a few days. Decorating is an inefficient use of your time.
It's important to forge a personal connection with your vessel. Make the ship your own. Ask Captain Janeway.
I'll discuss it with her the moment we return. The Delta Flyer is in fourth position, having completed 62% of the course. The Oxani vessel is in third position, having completed 68% of the course.
You don't make it sound very exciting.
I'm relaying the relevant information.
It's all in the delivery. Do you mind?
When I look at this, I don't see a mere cell. I see the potential for literature and art, empires and kingdoms.
this.
Perhaps your visual subroutines are malfunctioning.
Or you're famous.
Fame is irrelevant. I'll comply.
I sense a but coming.
It seems inefficient to save the life of someone who's about to be executed.
Your relationship with Lieutenant Paris.
I was speaking professionally. I often work with him on navigational problems. He can be an erratic individual. If you think my participation in the hoopla would be beneficial to others, then I'll comply.
Now three's changing course, using the gravity from a gas giant to boost its speed. It's making up for lost ground.
Sounds like quite a race.
Apparently, it's all in the delivery.
Our doctor.
That's right. The photonic. If only you could have known him. Ruggedly handsome. A sharp wit, a towering intellect. If he and I hadn't been colleagues. But now we'll never know what heights he could have reached.
Since you're new here, you may not be fully familiar with the labor protocols, but you should be aware that fraternizing is not permitted during work hours.
And do you have a number, or maybe a name?
Annika Hansen.
And what exactly is your position here?
I'm the new efficiency monitor.
It's obvious your heart is in conflict.
My heart is functioning perfectly.
What's all this?
The picnic. According to my research, this is an appropriate third date. My personal life is none of your concern.
I wasn't aware you had a personal life.
I really think you should stay.
Never play hard to get with a hologram. Am I early?
No, you're right on time. Something wrong with the door?
I didn't think it would be discreet to be seen carrying flowers to the first officer's quarters.
Do you hear that? It's identical to the rhythm produced by the 8-chambered Katerian heart.
Something wrong?
Rapid pulse, respiratory distress. You may be having a reaction to the pulsar's radiation. We should get you to the medical bay.
No, I'm not going to the medical bay.
You starship captains are all alike. You can stare down the barrel of a phaser cannon, but you can't stomach a simple medical exam.
I don't need an exam to know what I'm suffering from.
I've been told that anticipation of the first kiss is often uncomfortable. I wanted to alleviate the tension.
That was very considerate of you. What about the second kiss?
I'd have to check the database. It may indicate.
Did you get a look at their computer?
During the one brief moment when the doctor wasn't indulging himself.
I think I've shown considerable restraint under the circumstances.
Kissing Rannick on the bridge, is that your idea of restraint?
Kissing? Not that it's any of your business, but if you must know, Rannick kissed me.
And the massage you got from Lieutenant Jaren?
Entirely therapeutic.
You became sexually aroused in my body.
What seems to be the trouble, one of three?
Two of three.
Sorry. They're triplets, you know.
It hurts when I do this.
Well, then don't do it.
Ow!
Don't be a baby. Now your bi-radial clamp's out of alignment. I got just the thing. It's a Klingon aphrodisiac, my own special blend. You'll be feeling better in no time at all. Seven.
You should remain still.
You have no idea how difficult it's been, hiding my true feelings all these years, averting my eyes during your regular maintenance exams. I know you could never have the same feelings for me, but I want you to know the truth. I love you, Seven.
Your cognitive algorithms are malfunctioning. The time might pass more easily if we disable his vocal processor.
Seven, I didn't see you.
I was just leaving.